Welcome back, ladies and gents. It's time to, I guess, suppose, conclude our Swedish derby, which you have so thoroughly prepared us for with just copious amounts, gratuitous, wanton amounts of Swedishery.
How do you say this again?
Dalahust.
Dalahust. So, for those of you who tuned in a bit late and didn't know what all the stuff on the table was, it's all Swedish stuff because it's a Swedish derby today. Even got these little biscuit things, which are apparently, like, we have a Swedish producer and his eyes lit up. We haven't let him eat any, of course, but I'm eating some. Well, I was. I'm not going to eat them now. But, of course, we will share them. I just remembered that we should share them with the rest of our team after the break, where I can come in and take the tin.
What's on us to take this stuff, James? You brought so much stuff. There's milk there, just sitting there going off. Or milk.
Yeah, there's milk. I don't know if producer Patrick wants milk, but if you want milk...
The Bila is quite popular. Bila.
Yeah, I've had the Bila before.
Or cars.
I think the horse... I mean, what do we do? Literally, the horse cost us £160. I think we should keep that.
I think we should get NIP players to sign it, or just Swedish players to sign it at the next finals. Whoever it is, just maybe all the Swedes could all sign it, and then we could give it away, I don't know.
But what if I want to keep it? Well, I don't want him to sign my horse. You can sign their own horse.
It's not your horse, though. It's a studio. It's part of the studio now.
Yeah, I want it to be part of the studio, not you know, let's just keep it. Or take it to the face at office. Because my dog is there, which Heaton very much likes, but he can't have. Maybe if Heaton wants the horse, he can have the horse, but he can't have my dog. That's for sure. Anyway, let us know what we should do with the horse. If you have ideas, you can tweet Dan, you can tweet me, you can tweet ETS League, or you can tweet Face It, all the Twitter accounts. Or you can tweet producer_Reese as well. Get on the Twitter to him. He likes Swedish things as well.
And so if you think the observing sucks, you can tweet at SuggyCSGO.
Wow. Just going to... That's... Okay. Fnatic are going to be starting on the CT side, which means there's a reasonable chance we're going to get a more competitive map, Dad.
Absolutely. I mean, it's as Yanko pointed out so rightly on the desk, it's quite unpredictable, but therein lies its charm, I think. You never know what you're going to get, except some awesome plays, which I'm very much happy to settle with, whichever way they go. Here comes the push. Oh, good God.
That's a bad miss.
That's not how you want to start things off, is it? Crater from Dennis. Now Olaf Meiser wraps around the side there. Finds himself some good angles, but he gets snapped. Snapped up by JW. Oh God, that's a very open plant, James. That's a very open plant with no cover. And the price has been paid. Now JW is wondering, how do I plant this bomb? There's players all over the place.
I love the open plant, but maybe not on the pistol round. Even I wouldn't go for that. Massive gamble taken by Lecrobe, but sometimes... I mean, if you know it's a gamble that you want to take,
they could have had a safe plant, James. They could have had the safe plant and the man advantage.
Yep, they could.
He had no cover. He had no cover, James.
That's why it's a gamble, Dan. That's why it's a gamble.
He's out there in the cold alone.
That's why it's a gamble. He took the gamble. It didn't work.
It's a massive gamble, James.
It's quite the gamble, Dan. So Grimms is over towards the connector area. Disco Doplan, formerly of Dirty Dildos, will be holding the distraction in the meantime. Grimms creeping out now. Flusher. Waiting for a defuse sound. He can hear the defuse attempt from there, as can Pronex. Crims now, oh my God, Dan, this could be falling apart for Fnatic. This is the round they were supposed to win. He's holding the defuse, but no longer. Pronex still going to just let Flusher deal with it on his lonesome, and indeed, Fnatic don't get the start they wanted. How does the first kill of a pistol round start with a... How is it a crater? The first kill is a crater.
Wait,
look at me, Mum. Oh, no. I made a terrible mistake.
I love the sign. Nicely done.
GG's.
Nicely done.
Production team on point today.
Yeah, that's pretty godlike. I didn't even know that existed.
Yeah, me neither. I'm even more impressed.
Yeah. Guys in production must be nerds, James. So we've got 4v4. Here, straight away, it's the madness ensues. We get the aggression of Fnatic in this force buy going straight into the push of Godsent. They're going to come up a man short, though. In the overhead exchange. It's unfortunate for them. However, they still have two scouts, and where there are scouts on train, there are perhaps opportunities. It's a very good map for the scouts, I would say. Lots of long channels, lots of cover to abuse your mobility with. However, it's going to be very tough because there is still some utility here. A couple smokes, and the bomb will go down without too much issue. As some people say.
Doplan now with 1 HP. Is he going to crater as well? He is running away. Twist if he got another kill, then maybe Dopplan would come running back for support. But Twitch can just keep trying to pepper these players in the meantime. Well, it seems he's given up as well. So Disco Dopplan, formerly of Dirty Dildos, should be able to save his scout. I honestly love the scout. I love it so much.
You feel so free. You feel pure and true.
You're
freedom.
Like a bird in the sky. And I'm not even talking about jump scouting. It's just so...
You just like move around so quickly. I don't know. It just feels amazing. Yeah.
When you run scoped in and you strafe cancel and shoot someone straight in the head and then continue running and it doesn't even look like you stopped running. It's so glorious. It's so, so glorious. It's a very satisfying weapon. And you must cover it with holographic MLG stickers because of how awesome it is. I actually tweeted a picture of a link to a YouTube video of Dan on Mirage where he did a 180 swipe, no scope, straight in someone's face through a box when they shot at him, which is one of the most gangster shots I've ever seen in Counter-Strike, honestly. Anyway, Fnatic have that one scout now onto Twist as Dopplan was peeking with his 1 HP and he got taken down by a nice high peek from Godsent, an undetected peek. Fnatic's, their buy round is going to have to be spectacular. They did go for the force buy though, which means they will be limited in utility. We saw their plays with next to no utility on the T side. Hopefully the CT side is not the same.
Yeah, hopefully. But from what we did see, little that we did see of Godsend's T side last time, they did look very good there. I mean, they had a lot of nice rounds, and I think you highlighted we highlighted quite thoroughly, you know, some of those rounds where they just play for the bomb plants, all these extra things that Fnatic weren't doing on their T side. So it does definitely give them favor for me now, having seen that first performance. Now though, Fnatic, they don't have any grenades going into this. We'll have to see if they're going to be able to perform in their first buy round. Lekro taken down immediately, almost through the smoke, I think. And now there's problems here for Godsend potentially, unless they beat the rotation, which looks like they will. Dennis stays up alive in the upper areas now on B, and this is a big problem. Keeping that flank threat alive, still gets another frag. Oh my god, James, he's going to win the round by himself.
Dennis on the CT side has been somewhat spectacular, at least in comparison to the T side, doing great work for his team again. Three kills for him. Disco Dopplan, formerly of Dirty Dildos, will clean up the rest of them. And that's Fnatic's first round on the board. The second kill is so impressive as well, because look at the angle. Schneider just flies off the ladder there, but he still takes him down. And then Pronax has no cover. No cover at all. Good start from the buy round onwards for Fnatic, but they can't rely on Dennis getting three kills every round. I mean, he did rack up the kills in the first game, and he is a super strong player, one of the best in the game, but they need to play as a team to get themselves back in, or get themselves in the lead. Initial smoke grenades coming down from Godsend. They could commit to this. They've got Flush and Lekro close towards Pop Dog.
Yeah, Crims is there on the bomb train as well, trying to go for the delay here. That's a great Molotov. That forces Crims straight back off the bomb train, which makes Godsend's life easier as they press onto the bomb site. Less angles to worry about, perhaps, but Crims still just looking, peeking over that that Molotov on the train, is able to get the first frag here. Lekro is going to search him, or search for him rather, but he can't find it. Very nicely done so far by Fnatic. Look how they're creating a space, creating a vacuum within the site, allowing the plant to go down, but maintaining a superior positioning. And that's allowing them to just clean up these players. But there's still a chance here for Godsend. Pranax could go huge. That's the first frag. Nice flash comes in. Pranax can't get the follow-up. Flash is alone on 4 HP, and that is not going to work out too well for him. So the round will be claimed here by Fnatic. And again, I absolutely love that they let the plant go down, and they all positioned around it, created a perimeter.
Nicely done by Fnatic, surviving with two players. I'm curious as to what Godsent will choose to do, bearing that information in mind. He may try to go for a buy and break Fnatic now, or they'll go for the passive route. Seems it will be the latter because JW's picked up a Deagle. And indeed, see, I mean, this isn't really the buy I was talking about because only two players have Kevlar, but we have a Tech 9 and grenades buy from Godsent. A bit cheaper than the ideal one, but the same idea is in mind. Three smoke grenades on the Godsent side. So they could execute towards B and try to get to the other side of the bomb site. Fnatic may be reading some early B aggression again. Normally the CTs at the moment would start with four in A and one in B, but they're playing very close to connector indeed.
Well, if not able to connect there on the initial spray down Dennis though, he's always going to be connecting. This guy is absolutely monstrous. Couple kills for him. Is there more? Yes, there is. Four kills. Looks for the ace now. Just Pronax. And Dennis is going to get himself that cheeky ace. Of course, Godsend were just playing for the plant ultimately, but that could have been so much more had Dennis not been just absolutely on point.
Yeah, Dennis is simply so good. Was sad to see him leave FaZe, but was glad to see him join Fnatic. Double orbs coming out now. Twist and Olafmeister will be wielding, and definitely, I mean, obviously Dennis is capable of orping as well, as is Doplan, but why would on earth would you put an orb on Dennis when he is playing in this form on the CT side? I would imagine, I don't know, would you put Olaf or Twist as the primary AWP on this team? I mean, they don't even need to have a primary AWP in fairness.
No, yeah, exactly. It's, you know, whoever feels it on the map at the time. It's just like, it's so hard to say because all those players, I'd probably be leaning more towards Twist and having Olaf as, like, picking it up as a secondary most of the time. But it's really hard to say. I'm sure they just make the decision based on how, like, a mix of how they feel and also, you know, specific to sides and maps, potentially. But Godsend, I feel like they're just going to go for that A play here. They haven't pressured Ali at all. They haven't really shown much presence towards B at the moment. And they do have loads of nades, though. So, and in contrast to Fnatic, who don't have very many. So they could play slower to waste those grenades. But instead, looks like they're just going to go for the play into the A bomb site from just 2 points, Pop Dog and T-Main. Oh.
Dun, dun, dun. Tune in next week to find out what happens in round 7 of Fnatic versus Godsend, map 2 on train. Dun, 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 dun. 9, 8. It's turning into like a Thunderbird launch countdown now. 4, 3. And we're back in the studio, and the horse is still here. How do you say the horse again?
Dalihist.
Dalihist.
I think it's Dalihist. Is Dalihist or Dalihist? I'm not sure which one it is. I don't even know what it means. It probably means wooden horse. I'm pretty sure. That must be it, right?
Dali Hust.
Hust kind of sounds like horse. So well, Dali must be wood.
I can't imagine they have a T on horse, though. Hust.
Why not?
Because, I mean, just I don't see how in a foreign language you can get something that sounds like horse, that is horse, but has a T on it. To me, I would say that doesn't. That's not. What is this wrong with this damn cable?
Maybe we can get one of our producers, producer Patrick, to confirm he is Swedish. In fact. Wait.
We're just sitting in quiet while. What does it mean, Patrick? What does Dala Hest mean?
What does it mean?
Oh, it's an area of Sweden. Okay, so Dala is an area of Sweden.
What does Hest mean?
So your language skills. Completely fraudulent.
Oh, it does mean horse.
Yeah, but you said it means wooden horse, but Dale is like an area.
I got half right. You said that you don't think that horse can be horse, and you're wrong,
James.
Oh,
that's true. Yeah. Okay. Fine. Okay. We're both fraudulent.
So I kind of at least win a little bit. You just lose that right completely. So I'm fine with that.
That is actually quite fair. I can't even argue that one.
Yeah.
So what has happened to our game? Somebody needs to tell us because
We're in the dark.
The server crashed, kicked everyone.
Okay. So this might be a few minutes. I think there was a server bug. So our studio smells of fish now. For those of you who weren't here earlier, we got out the...
Add some context,
it's
please.
It's actually called caviar.
Yes. Oh, yes.
Kalle's
caviar.
Kalle's caviar.
Kalle actually is the Swedish equivalent of Carl, actually, the name Carl. That is actually true.
Producer is trolling me. He should stop.
Was he saying to you? Because I didn't hear
He said he could provide some more caviar.
Oh.
But no, because the studio smells of it now, and it's not a nice smell. It's not a nice smell.
I haven't even opened the sustroming yet.
Yeah, we've been threatening to do that. Even the woman who sold it to us said, don't open this, but take this. So
don't open it inside. Open it outside.
Yeah, open it outside. But there is no outside. We're in the studio. Can't even see the sun. So if we do open it, it will be in this enclosed space. Although I don't think I'm that brave. I was almost hurling, even looking at you squeezing the tube of caviar.
It was making weird sounds as well. Didn't really help.
Didn't help. Yeah. No.
We could just like just pierce it slightly. Just that little,
no.
Little,
no. Why?
There's,
no.
There's nothing.
No. If you want to cast on your own, then by all means. But otherwise, the answer is no.
It's probably a bad idea.
It is a bad idea. If the woman who sells it to you says, don't open it, something terrible is inside. Inside. Someone had those big round bread things, those hard bread things, and butter and the caviar, and tweeted a picture of us eating it while he's watching the stream, he or she, so whoever you are. Props to you for eating that. And again, it's clearly one of those things that you have to get used to as a kid. Right, like an acquired taste, otherwise, and smell, otherwise, it's just going to be horrible for you. So I think it's a wartime food. I think wartime foods are always cool, you know, back in the days of rations and things. But that's enough about that. It might be a few minutes until this game is resumed, so we're going to go to a short break, and when we're back, the rest of match two between these two teams. See you back here soon.
I actually muted my mic. Out of panic, James. We're watching some interesting videos.
That was amazing.
Yeah.
So someone got the Sir Strumming stuff around a fork and tried to feed it to their dog, and their dog sniffed it and it just puked all over the floor.
Thanks for the
Just watching that just before we came back. It was hilarious. You have to have you retweeted that?
No.
That's amazing.
Do you want me to retweet it?
Absolutely, yeah.
So right now.
So we had a suggestion from Bobby Doug on Twitter, who said, put caviar on the Dalahoust and let DDK shove the Dalahoust up Bardolph's ass. That's actually
a
suggestion.
Why would you read that on the stream, James?
Why not?
It's a bit vulgar. A bit lewd.
I'm just quoting. This is what he said. It's like mean tweets, isn't it? Put the Dalahoust up Bardolph's ass.
Brilliant.
Mean tweets.
It's definitely mean. Anyway, Counter-Strike. We're back with the Counter-Strike. They've reloaded the map. They've, of course, used the match medic and all that. And we are where we left off. 3-4. Fnatic trailing a little bit. And as you can see, their economy has seen better times. Double AWP, however. So despite the lack of utility, the awful and terrible lack of utility, they will have lots of options unless the smokes of God's sake take those options away, because they need those long areas of vision. But that said, in comes Fnatic's Olofmeister with the Mag 7. Would have liked to perhaps get both of those kills. Unlucky not to get them both. And that's actually kind of interesting, because I think most of the time he's getting both of those kills, and that puts Fnatic at a great advantage, but they actually traded one for one, so that's brilliant for Godsend, in fact. And it looks like they're ready to go for the A play off the back of that.
So Dennis is somewhat out of position for a play towards A in the middle of B. So he's not fast on the rotate. So there's weakness for Fnatic, unbeknownst to them. Twist is over towards Ivy, and Dopplands, you can see his position right there. All the flash forces him away, but JW's going to have to go for the repick, not fast enough to get the kill, and he's going to need that backup. We've got Dennis, he's forced to rotate through CT spawn, which is going to slow him down quite a lot. Fnatic going to be unable to stop the bomb from going down in this situation. Again, two orbs on this retake, looking really awkward for him. No smoke's going to be up for a while. The Grosser Woods electric box. They're just biding their time, Godsend. JW vulnerable on the site, gets the first kill, that one's a Crims. Dopplan creeping around the corner, and there it is. But how do they get this bomb defused? Oh, like we're going for a ninja. Trades coming in though from the T side. Flusher popping out, there goes Dopplan. Dennis is spotted, and he's going to have to give this one up. Godsend extend their lead.
Yeah, no, if I'm not mistaken, Fnatic's money is going to be a bit broken after this. Yeah, you can see that they're all out of cash, and this will be their second round loss in a row. So they're not going to have all that much to go with in this round, except the AWP that's being saved by Dennis, and perhaps whatever meager pistols are purchased into the beginnings of this round. Like perhaps a couple P250s might be in order, and that's probably all we're going to see in addition to Dennis's AWP to really help Fnatic out in this next round to do damage, because that's all they can really hope to accomplish in this round, is to keep Godsend's economy a little bit honest with some damage. So how are they going to try to accomplish this?
Yeah, Dennis, the one man with the saved gun for Fnatic, is going to have to go nuclear. Being smoked off immediately with his gamble play. Olofmeister can't get the one tap. Got some shots through the smoke, but nothing too fatal. Twist should go down as well. So Pronex just pretty much clearing everyone up, and there's going to be so much time to hunt Dennis. Holding angles towards the site from the back. JW taken down, but again, we'll see what Crims can do. Let's see, that's Lecro, who should hear Crims running towards main. Pronex walking into vision. Not the best idea when you know your opponent has an AWP. Three players left for Godsend, and things are getting a bit scary for them now, so they may have to hold position. And indeed, Dennis may save this AWP for the next round.
That's a pretty good result overall, and Godsend, I mean, they are taking a lead once again. It's not as clean as the first map, but that map, they did win the pistol on the CT side, and they just didn't look back from there. But at the same time, it looks like they're starting to generate some momentum. And this, if they're able to take this next round, that's going to be quite telling as to how this map's going to go, I feel like. Because that's when things start to really get away from Fnatic. And once again, their economy's in a poor state. They have to eco again. Godsend's opportunities to build and build their lead into double digits only increases from that point forward. So Fnatic definitely need to turn the tide right now. And it's trained, so it's hard to get aggressive. So they're at the mercy of Godsend. They just have to deliver the shots, trust each other, and get some good calling going on as far as the info goes, and also try not to get picked by Schneider.
Lecro making his way towards the bomb train. All of my Sonya on the other side of that brown train. Angles being held by a twist towards the IV position. Lecro will be able to advance. Still on his own in the A bomb site. Twist is charging through. Gets the kill as well. Meanwhile, Lofmeister has been taken down by Pronax. He's got control of the pop dog. Susceptible to grenades, though. Just in Molotov on Dennis and Doplan to threaten him. Schneider picked off now. Two players towards pop for Godsend. Maybe waiting for JW to get a pick and just pull players away from their focus.
Playing the time. That is one of the commodities that they have, one of the few commodities. Although it's slowly running out and they will be forced into action. We have the bomb moving towards B at the moment in the hands of Flusher. Perhaps he can be the one to make the play. However, they would probably want JW to do it instead, as we can see, starting to move through alley. If he can create distraction, and with the CT still yet to see the bomb, there's still obscurity for the CT. So that's the best way to make this work. Spots the barrel. Good start here from JW. Gets the advantage. Execution onto Disco Doplan. And that's going to allow Flusher all the space he needs to get the plant. An open plant as well. And all of a sudden, things get rather complicated here for Fnatic.
It's a side plant. Question now is, can JW make his way onto the B bomb site to actually help his teammate out? Krims is looking. They're all focusing on JW in the A site. No one's actually trying to go for the bomb at the moment. Krims is still in connector, trying to kill the JW. Do they think it's the A site? Is that what's going on right now? Because there goes Dennis and Krims on the A site as well. And JW is going to clutch. He's going to clutch defending the A site where the bomb wasn't even planted with a 4K in total.
That was a 1v4, basically. That's unreal. With a rifle, JW.
On the wrong bombsite, Dan.
On the wrong bombsite, yes.
He clutched on the wrong bombsite.
It's amazing as well because JW, I think in the last year or so, his rifle skills have just been getting better and better. Yeah, awesome, awesome clutch from JW. And that is what a way for Fnatic to lose a round, not only which was incredibly important, it was a round where they had a pretty big advantage.
It was the wrong bombsite, Dan. They lost a round on the wrong bombsite. I mean, they clearly had no idea that the bomb was not on A.
Or potentially just want to make sure that they eliminate the flank straight away.
Yeah, but they could use the numbers game to isolate the player who has the bomb and then who's defending the bomb. And then
it did look more like they didn't realize, but I'm not sure.
Yeah, it could be that they're trying to eliminate the flanker, but to me, in most situations like that, you want to isolate the player who's planted a bomb and then force the other guy to run and stop the bomb from being defused, therefore exposing himself in an unfavorable position. I mean, maybe it just went wrong because he kept killing players, but there we go.
So, is it a Fnatic now that's really lost their best opportunity to get back into this first half at the very least? It could well be the case, we'll have to find out. But right now, it's just a case of Fnatic once again trying to do damage, or if they find a situation where they can't get a frag, then they maybe save these guns into next round. But that's a nice pickup there for Krims. Uses the 5-7, gets himself an AWP. Now this is interesting because Godsend are likely going to be able to build a lot of money, so they can sacrifice a lot of players to get rid of this AWP, and they don't have to lose a single one. That's a beautiful, beautiful end to the round for Godsend.
Yeah, so Fnatic, they had three rounds from the first buy round onwards, and then it's five rounds in a row for Godsend, which means maximum loss bonus for Fnatic, which means two AWPs are now coming out once again onto Twist and Olafmeister once again. But will they have more success starting with that default four CT players in the A bomb site? We've got three players going towards IV for Godsend. Twist is over there, currently looking towards main, but he will have a butcher's hook at these players. Pronax goes down for absolutely free for gratis. No second player spotted, but a grenade may tell a story.
Looking good for Fnatic right now. 3v5 for them to deal with. They don't have to make any alterations to their setup. That said, Dennis is potentially pushing here, and if Flusher turns around in time, He could get an easy engagement. Oh, but it's Dennis who spots Flusher on the peripheral, takes him out. And now it's Fnatic in a 5v2. So just picked apart piece by piece, godsend in this round, until there's only JW and Lecro left. And this is not a good look, as Olaf Meister has his attention to where both players are. Nice little smoke out of the position, though. Lecro with one frag, JW with another one. So all of a sudden, we have a 2v3 on our hands. Is this actually doable?
They've got time, some time, but the position is, their positions are somewhat known, roughly, and there's a man advantage for the CT side. They've got control of the bomb site as well. Delaying Molotovs come in. There goes Lecro. So it's JW with the bomb. His reload should give his position away. Indeed, you see the flashbang going straight over his head. Dennis with the 1v1, and he will deliver, as he often does. So Fnatic get back to winning ways, though. What is scary is the T's have more money than them, and there are still more rounds to fight for in this half.
I think this frag here onto Lecro, I believe Lecro is in a position where he felt like he crossed and Disco Dolphin didn't see him. I think that's what he thought. And I think he's told JW to wait for him to make the play onto that player. Because if he gets that kill onto Disco Dolphin, they can probably win the round with JW then popping out afterwards. But wasn't to be in the end. And a quick round into the yard is the call for Godsent as they toss in all their utility. And the rotation of the flank is something that could be dangerous. Dennis is just waiting for the perfect moment to come in.
That grenade onto Olaf Meister is going to take him out of the game. And this is it heavily. This could go either way. Advantage is real for Godsent at the moment, but things can quickly change, especially with Dennis coming in from the back. Twist is distracting all of these players. The bomb plant comes in, and Dennis is not going to make an attempt to try and stop it from going down. Although it's fake. Down goes Twist, and now Dennis will emerge. Can he get another clutch? No. Just the one kill for him. Another round in the bag for Godsent, and indeed, Fnatic do get reset on the economy. It was a threat. And the threat is real.
Yeah, Godsent, they are playing really well at the moment. I mean, they're getting their clutches. They have, you know, good coordination. I think the communication as well between the players has looked pretty solid so far as well. And Train isn't the most complex of maps for that, but it's always good to see a team that's hitting their stride. And that's what we're seeing so far from Godsent. Perhaps another fairly quick play into the A yard here. That is the order of the day. That is the business for Godsent as they come in.
Will Dennis be spotted though? He's on the ladder. There he is, taking them by surprise, trying to fly with the USP. Not going to work out for him though. Two pistol players remain here for Fnatic. And 4v2, even with the one odd frag here or there, it's still got a lot of work to do for these guys. Twist alone, I don't know where he is, but they're giving him 1v1. So continuation spray, just in case the trade fragger came in. Schneider will entertain and then send the final bullets Twist's way. 10-4. Fnatic get their last buy over the first half.
I like the ragdoll in this game. Dennis actually looked like he was a seal shot out of a cannon, the way that he kind of went, you know, his trajectory in the air there and how he landed. Very interesting stuff. 4-10 indeed. Fnatic, they really desperately could use this last round, get them a bit more to work with in that second half. And Godsent, they've been finding so much success going for the fast plays into air. You can see the counter grenades start to come in as an adjustment from Fnatic. However, Godsent have realized that that is very realistic, very likely after their recent rounds. And so they're slowing things down. They're slowing their pace down so they don't get caught out by the quick grenades. And now Fnatic, after those quick pre-nades early in the round, anti-rush nades perhaps, they're down to almost no utility. So this is exactly what Godsent wanted. They've set them up now. And if they were to run a set piece, there wouldn't really be much in the way of counter grenades to stop it.
JW with an opening frag towards Ivy, backing off just in case. Trying to entertain the players, but he is being ignored like Stalker on Facebook, Dan. No one's over towards Ivy at the moment, and JW is continuing to try and harass. Meanwhile, Dennis having a read that perhaps it could be B going for some shoulder peeks, but he has to jump up to get a proper peek there, which does have increased risk. Olaf Meister on the B-bomb site as well. Ooh, Twist doing great damage despite getting naded. Naded next to nothing to him, surprisingly. But down he goes, down Dennis goes as well. Is it A, is it B? Fnatic have no idea, and they're running out of personnel with which to stop this push.
Godsent just simply looking a little bit too good today so far. And I wonder if we'll have a similar CT half. But first, Godsent have to close this round. Sure, they have every advantage, but they don't have the information just yet. There is a little bit of information, but it comes at a heavy price. Same can be said for Olaf Meister's positioning.
10 seconds.
Now, this is very, very likely a Fnatic round. There's just no time to pick up the bomb. They have to get the kills. Necro, 2 seconds to find the frag, and Crims will never show himself. So the round is actually won by Fnatic in the end, so that's a good effort, but 5-10. If you look at how poor their T-half was originally and how one-dimensional it was, it's hard to see them coming back in this.
It is. If they lose the pistol, then there's some breathing room, but it's by no means is it a lot. Let's see if they can take a pistol round in this match. They were so close to winning the pistol in the first place. And imagine what would have happened. They got 5 rounds on the board without the pistol. So who knows? But we can only imagine. No, Godsent didn't have the range. The range advantage of the CT side. Dennis is going to be on a P250 this time. So no raid boss. All the players of armor have got Kevlar. Lovely patient shot there from Pranak straight into the head of Olaf Meister. Dennis getting taken down. Oh, this is not looking good for the Fnatic side. Crims and Dopplan, they've been heard. The firing squad is here. Where will they go? There's no safe haven for them. It's like Prison Break, Dan. It's Prison Break! It's like, what are those brothers called?
I don't know, mate. It's been a long time since I saw it.
Oh, what this brother's called! God damn it. Never mind.
I'm sure someone will tweet you the answer. Well,
dead now, of course. Lincoln Burrows and some other guy had a different last name. Anyway, 11-5.
Yeah, Godsent with that first round CT pistol victory. It was the 16th round, but whatever. The pistol victory on the CT side, that's the important thing. That's what got them so far ahead on the first map. We see the similar story. We got the Force Buy out of Fnatic, but they have no utility, absolutely none. That is definitely quite a tough situation, especially on train. Whereas Janko described before, attacking without any utility to kind of make your angles easier or have to worry about less angles when you come in, your life is very hard. And we can see that is the case here. A couple kills come out in the end, but it's just Olaf Meister left. He's picked up an MP9 and an HE. It is a sorrowful upgrade.
Minute 12. It was interesting. Crims was jumping around in main earlier. Then as he moved away, Olaf Meister moved in as the CT tries to push with the MP9. So there we go. Olaf Meister needs some more one versus ones, but doesn't have enough health to do it. Burrows and Schofield. I forget the guy's first
Schofield,
name.
Yeah,
but
this is great though for Godsent. They don't care that they lost three players there because Fnatic are on full eco right now. And also a lot of the weapons that you might want to buy with kind of not the optimal economy, like FAMAS and Mag7s and so on, they're fairly usable on train, as you can work with a lot of close and medium ranges if you choose to, into that anti-buy round, as it were, for Godsent.
Where is Senor JW? There he is, and he's dead now, of course. Schneider running out of bullets, surely. Oh, that's an awkward way. Landing knee first, trying to breakdance, but he's dead. Dead breakdancing, not going to catch on as a sport. So, the question is, can a tease pull the rotation towards the B bomb site? Olaf Meister's going to go down over there. Dennis is down as well. Lecro getting nice tags through the smoke. Needs to reload though. Flushes in for support, but he's running out of a USP flusher. These players don't have armor, however, so that might be an interesting end to the round. We'll see if Flusher can collect anything now, because he's literally got a USP and nothing else. And he can't. That's curious. $8,000 in the bank, though. Godsent 3 rounds away from a solid 2-0. Over Fnatic, or 1-0-1-0, which makes more sense, but there we go.
Problems. Big problems. At least there is some utility for Fnatic in this round. I wonder if they feel like things are getting a little bit hopeless at this point. Well, already, I can see 3 kills straight away.
Well, I guess they are then.
Yeah, aggressive setup here from Godsent. They just meet the push and they win all their engagements. It's more or less as simple as that. Good stuff there from Godsent. Another quick kill from Flusher, as the remainder of Fnatic is now just a single man in Disco Dotplan. And he is wondering, what the hell do I do in this position? He's just going to go for it, looking for the first engagement. Gets the kill, actually. Long range spray down. Oh, almost gets Flusher. It was very low, but it will not be for Disco Dotplan in this 1v5. Instead, a Godsent round, and they are now 2 away.
Force buy coming in from Fnatic. Do they have a plan behind the force buy though? Or are they tilted into Planet Zarg? We will find out. The Tech Nines coming up. Tech Nines that we should have seen in the first game at some point, in my humble opinion. Fnatic going through the showers towards the B bomb site where Lecro awaits. And Flusher, I mean, he's got his AWP out, which makes sense. So I think Flusher will be the initial peek. And then once he sees something, Lecro can peek out as well. Lovely stuff from them. Two kills for Lecro. The Molotov comes down for Flusher. The no scope for Twist as well. And things are looking brutal and brief for Fnatic in this round.
Yeah, no kidding. Fnatic are getting absolutely schooled at the moment by their Swedish counterparts, their ex-comrades in many cases. But it happens in a Swedish derby, in a derby of any kind. Ridiculousness. The ludicrous is expected.
Ludicrous?
Yes. I don't think we're seeing 14-5 scorelines every single time here, but today Fnatic are having a struggle, having a hard time. Dennis will go down in the end. Dennis has been doing mad amounts of work as well. Like, he's really been trying to keep his team in this.
Dennis is a beast.
Across both maps, Dennis had amazing performances. He is absolutely just a crazy, crazy good player.
That was a nice shot. But the setup from the side, from Lecro and Flush, was really good as well. I mean, you often see players with rifles or snipers holding that angle that Flusher is holding, but you should always be flashed off that angle, at least at the beginning of the round. 4x versus 4x. JW coming in for a push, not going to work out for him. Pronax is going to get traded. Man advantage for Fnatic, though. Are they going to move fast with this? No, doesn't seem so. Top line over towards the Ivy area. Moving forward now that Dennis gets that pick, Schneider is very vulnerable indeed. So far, so good. Goes back to top line as well. Just above his head. Top line with a lovely crouch there, leaving Flusher alone in the 1v3. They're all moving out. They don't want to give any picks up to Flusher, who is backing up. Taking the wrong angles towards Pop Dog, surely Olaf Mice is going to take him down. There it is. Fnatic down, but not out of it yet.
Not just yet, no. But the threat is looming, and it will almost forever feel like it's looming, as it's such a long climb to get back to, well, to get to overtime. Some grit and determination is required. Dennis has been delivering, but now we get double AWP here. Both JW and Pronax pick up the AWPs here for the Godsent side. And considering that Fnatic haven't been super utility heavy in a lot of spots, can definitely support the double AWP decision. Pronax and JW playing both AWPs from Ali's side, which is awesome to see as well. Not the most common thing you would see. Typically, the player in Pronax's position is more likely going to have a rifle, and then the AWP is in the more dynamic position, able to react and respond. Again, it's something you see from Fallen very often. Nice. Oh. Pronax drops Twist.
Adjusted it for the crouch as well, which is lovely. And now, I'm not sure if they'll realize there's two AWPs, or if it's one. But they're moving, so you can see them starting to walk now. If you're close to main, you can hear people running in those hallways. And that does give a lot of information for the CT side. So, Fnatic, I can't imagine they're all going to run through Pop Dog. That said, three of them have gone down the ladder, Dan. So it seems they're all going to run through Pop Dog. This may be the gauntlet run to end all gauntlet runs. Doplan going for a basic fake towards B-bomb site. And it seems he's moving in there as well. There are still two CTs, though. He'll keep him entertained. And indeed, here comes that run. Schneider can only get one, though. JW coming for the flank, but Dennis appears to have heard him. There goes JW, 3v3.
Yeah, very even stuff here, but Fnatic have a lot of pressure because that time is starting to play quite the problem, but they realize at least Olaf Mice is going to spot. Oh no, he doesn't see the player over the smoke. We can see more than he can. And that initial kill comes in. By splash of the time, the space to work with, but Dennis, once again, ever reliable here for Fnatic, picks up the round. And one more added to the tally. Up to 7 now, but still against that 15.
Speaking of 7, 23rd round, and Crimson's only got 7 kills at the moment. At the bottom of the scoreboard, obviously, Dennis is at the top. I am Dennis Fan 1 on most days. So, this is interesting. Double AWPs versus an Eco. We'll see how aggressive Godsent choose to be. Pronax through the middle of Ivy once again. He is Molotovable from that angle, although with Doplan there by himself, I'd be surprised if he was facing with a Molotov. That said, could bounce it off the wall. Pronax, with good timing, takes Doplan down as an AK to be collected if he's fast enough. Lovely stuff. He can get out there now. JW taking down towards main in the meantime. So no, nobody in a bomb site just yet. But two players moving towards pop once again. Twist missing a shot. Are they going to commit to this? No smokes down anywhere on the site. Pronex gets traded. There's the AK gone. So it's Schneider and Flusher now. Different positions. Schneider would do well to stay alive here. Oh, that's a lovely shot to Twist as well. Two players left here for the T side. Still no guns picked up by Flusher, but maybe there is a weapon around this position. Oh, patient play with the P250. Pepper's one of these players. They're both taggable. That was doable for Flusher. 5-7 would have been a lot nicer. Probably would have got a kill there, unfortunately, for him. Seven rounds between these two sides.
Yeah, and there's so many opportunities for Godsend to get that final round that they need. And now their loss bonus is starting to really build. And again, they need one round, so if they lose this round, they'll be up to $2,900. And then, again, the following round, the fifth in a row, will be $3,400. So the next round, they'll have a decent amount of pistols and someone to play with. So it just gets harder and harder for Fnatic at this point to take Godsent down. And already we're going to see that early in the round, a big exchange of utility to slow Fnatic down. And we go back into the picking style here from Fnatic. The boost, okay, boost not required. Twist picks up the kill onto Necro, and he gets himself in to a forward position.
Early advantages for Fnatic. Doplan rotating the bomb, maybe. I don't know, he's just going to execute some grenades into the A side, but JW picks off Olafmeister all too quickly. Schneider gets taken down in response, so there's still a man advantage for the T's. Moving in, Twist is in a position, trying to maybe cut off a CT moving through from Ivy, and that's where Pronax is at the moment. We'll see if the waiting game works out. JW, what kind of frag was that? That was gross!
He shot off his feet, James, but still, it's looking tough for Godsent. Flusher is going to back away into connector because he realizes, again, low health, and they have to plant the bomb. And he can still have time to double back. So Flusher playing it smart. And at the same time, Pronax is doing another smart play. He might get the information and catch them both, but it's very unlikely that they'll go alley. But at the same time, if they plant A, they'll never expect Pronax to be coming from that angle, from T main or from the pop log area. But that's unfortunate for Pronax. Can't get the information in time, and he will be losing Flusher as he makes his slow approach. Now it's all on him.
So he just ran a little bit, as far as he could run without being detected. There's a fair chance he could just walk down the stairs because there are so many places for these guys to aim. But will he kill Dennis straight away? I'm not sure if he spotted Dennis just there. But he could walk past Dennis and find out where Doplan is. Oh no, he's going to go for the frag straight away. That was the information play, Pronax. Doplan on the site. Seems he heard a step. The peek comes in, but Doplan can't get it. Oh man, I really feel like there was a bigger play to be made by Pronax there. But he just went for a snap reaction. I think a lot of players would have just walked past Dennis in that situation.
Yeah, there was like a really big blind spot opportunity with that peek that we saw. I mean, there was a gamble being taken by Fnatic there. And it wasn't quite exploited. But Pronax perhaps, not comfortable with that play, making the play that he felt would be his best chance to win the round. But that time it didn't come to fruition. But as I mentioned previously, pistols here to just harass Fnatic. They have to remain disciplined every single round. There is no margin for error. So these anti-ecos have to be spot on. Krim's going for a bit of a JW play, just trying to shoot people's feet out underneath the trains. And one by one, Godsent will be at the mercy of these high-powered rifles, themselves only wielding meager pistols. Well, the Deagle's not too meager, but still. Round over, four players alive for Fnatic. Five rounds to go for overtime.
The road to recovery continues for Fnatic, and now it's Godsent's turn, as it was Fnatic's in the first game, to continuously lose rounds and then maybe not have an AWP anymore. Five rounds lost in a row, which means maximum loss bonus, $3,400. And if they're buying up maximum every round, so unless they go AWP, no armor, we're probably not going to see any AWPs. Even then, if they didn't have armor, they might still not have the money for it, because there's not much left in the bank there. Flusher might be able to bring one out next round, but let's see how this one goes. Olafmeister jumping into the angle, spotted by Flusher. He'll do some damage, but no kills for him. Default plant coming in this time, and Godsent It seems are going for the save.
Yeah, very sensible play. For Godsend, I mean, that bomb site is really well and truly lost. It's one of those situations where if you as the CTs can delay them from getting onto the B bomb site, or you get like two or three kills and then you die, those are two retakeable situations. But if you just get no kills and no delay at all, so they can take the entire yard, shut down the choke points, there is no hope. The percentages that you'll win that round are so incredibly low. And with players of this caliber, it just frankly comes down to you praying that they'll make a mistake instead of you forcing them into a situation where it's hard for them to know what the right call is and they end up making a mistake. Those are two very different ideas. And Godsend showing their appropriate respect to Fnatic, they save four rifles.
That save also means in a future round, they could pick up one, even two AWPs because they'll have that money in store. Only one person needs to buy up. Other than that, it's the odd grenade here and there. So you can see three players have almost $3,000, which means they're looking at 6,400 if they lose this round. So I like that decision. That could be the difference-making decision.
JW was so good on the AWP earlier. It's a bit of a sad case to not see him on it now. Oh, but speaking of, cheeky frag found with a rifle, tagging down Twist. Twist goes for the peak. He will be rewarded this time. JW biting off more than he could chew.
We've seen that same peak from Hen1 as well, where he just walked into the site on his own with an AWP. Didn't work out. Seems insane to me. Like, to look at it from the outside, it just looks bananas. But again, in a domestic matchup, when you know the habits of your opponents, maybe he had a read. It was a gamble, though. Didn't pay off. Maybe it's a gamble they can't afford to take against match point. We will find out, depending on how this progresses. That said, that would be outcome-oriented, which is never good. So we'll see what else they can do. Olafmeister moving towards the B bomb site on his own, though. Just lurking around, seeing if he can find himself an opening. But Flush is playing at the back. Both teams down a man at the moment. Lecro playing around the connector area. Twist might find himself a Lecro if he peaks at the wrong time. Ooh, Schneider with a lovely double dink. Ding dong.
How does he beat Twist there? That's kind of crazy, isn't it? He's got an M4, A1S. He needs to get two bullets on him on that pixel angle. How does that not be more favorable to the AWP? I'll never know, but the action ensues now as the bomb has to be planted. There's just no time to wait around anymore. This could be it for Fnatic. Their hopes all rest on Olafmeister. He's got 10 seconds. How can he win the round? He can't. It's impossible. He is being killed by Pronax, and that's a 16-11 final score. It was a great run from Fnatic to try to bring themselves back into contention, but seemingly it was just not to be.
I think Doplan went for a fake at the end there, and then the nade just came sailing in to take his face off. So that's a nice 2-0 for Godsend. Fnatic with a reasonable comeback towards the end, but ultimately it was just too much to ask. The thoughts of Yanko after the break.